Are you looking to be the fabled hero of your FNM? Do you want to demolish your opponents in the next PTQ? Check out channelfireball.com strategy content. We've got articles and videos from Hall of Fame players like Luis Scott Vargas, Paolo Vitor Damo de Rosa, and Ben Stark, as well as other incredible pros. While we can't teach you how to make puns like LSV, we're sure you'll learn a thing or two.
Hello everybody, this is William Jensen with a Theros block draft video for channelfireball.com. I have special guests today, Owen Turtenwald.
Hello.
He's going to help us out. here's our first pack. Not very good.
Nope.
I think we basically want to choose between Shrike Harpy and a Crow and Conscriptors.
I agree. Do you have a strong inclination for which one you like
better? I don't really like red very much.
Yeah, red's
cool. And although a lot of people whose opinion I respect said it, Conscriptors have been great for them, I have not had that experience. What do you think?
Same. I think Crone's Conscriptor is average, and Tricarpy is also average. I wouldn't be happy to first pick either one in a random draft.
I agree.
But they're the best cards in this pack, so.
What do you want to do?
I guess Conscriptor. I mean, my vote would just be take whichever one you like better, honestly.
All right, I'll take Conscriptor just because.
It's probably the best card in the pack.
Yeah.
Jeez, this is a bad pack. What are the best cards?
None.
Oathsworn, Shieldmate, Stratuswalk, yeah. It's like,
I kind of want to just take the Oathsworn.
I would not fault you for that. Not like Red-Green Heroic is great or anything, but you can reevaluate what comes later. And maybe Red-Green Heroic is good.
It could be fine, and I think it's just the best card.
Yeah, it is. It is the best card.
So, I think for that reason, I'm not married to the Conscriptor or anything.
I guess the Butcher? What do you think?
I could take Butcher, or I could take Spirit of the Labyrinth.
That would be okay. The thing is, you don't really want to go white-green. So, does that make sense that if you take the Spirit of the Labyrinth, you're effectively just taking a red card? Because white-green is so bad?
Sure, I could.
So you'd have to go white-red. I mean, you could go white-blue.
Blue, yeah.
But
I'll just take the Butcher, I guess.
I think the Butcher is the best pick.
Yeah.
Wow, annoying.
I think I should just take the Sun Guide or maybe the Shield Mate.
I would take the Sun Guide, I think.
Yeah.
Isn't that what you want to take?
Yes.
Yeah, so that's fine. I mean, it's really hard to go green-white is the thing.
Yeah. Is Sun Guide definitely better than Shield Mate?
I hadn't previously thought that, but I think it more now.
All right.
Like,
I mean, I do have one heroic card.
You really need to be very strongly into heroic to make the Shield Mate worth,
right,
worth
a
high pick, you know? Well, that's a late champion of the Stray Souls, I'll say that.
Yeah. I don't think that card's that good.
No, it's not, but it is a good card.
I think I just want to take Loyal Pegasus.
That's what I would take. I don't even find it to be too close either.
Yeah.
Loyal Pegasus is great.
All right, here. I actually think Elite Skirmisher is better than Ghostblade Eidolon.
It is. I think you think that because you're right.
So I'm just going to go and take it.
Yeah. Ghostblade Eidolon just routinely is disappointing.
Yeah. White-green isn't out of the question.
Do you wish you had a Spirit of the Labyrinth instead of the Butcher?
Yeah. Obviously. Yeah.
Ugh.
Yep. Should I just take a Stratuswalk?
Probably.
I mean, I could take a Karametra's Favor.
Don't do that.
Yeah.
I would rather take, like, Serpent of Time Rift than a Favor.
I think I'm just going to take a premium version of Stratuswalk. Thoughts?
Obviously, that's good.
This deck is a mess.
Oh, yeah. I mean, we tried to go green, got past almost no good green cards, so there's no shame in that.
Yeah. Could still be white-red pretty easily.
Yes, of course. The most likely outcome is that you go white-red.
Yeah.
Ghostblade Eidolon looks like it's a good card. Jeez. The latest 68.
Should I just take it?
I don't know. I think I'd rather have the Morals Ardor.
Ugh, I hate that card.
It's because it's not good. I mean, you can take Asphyxiate.
Yeah, I'm gonna do that.
Provoke Existence.
Sure. At least it's somewhat playable.
It's true. I mean, you've been taking blue and green cards. When you took them, you were hoping to go blue or green.
Yeah.
And you've seen no good blue or green cards.
Yeah.
As well as black for the asphyxiate.
Or red.
Or red as well, yes. And it's not like getting past the loyal Pegasus, the Sun Guide, or a structure is going to make you think that white's open. They just have been impacts and you've taken them.
Yeah, there haven't been a, you know...
You have not seen one single strong signal.
Yeah, well, the black probably, actually.
Just the asphyxiate? And
the Champion of Stray Souls, maybe.
Oh, yeah. You have a pretty good black deck, actually, with the Champion of Stray Souls and the, what's the other one, Servant of Time, isn't it?
Should I just take Marsh Mist Titan?
I guess, I mean...
I could take Karametra's Favor.
It's just not that good of a card.
Yeah, neither is Marsh Mist Titan, though. Guess I'll take the tree.
You really think you're going to go black after what you pass?
I don't know. You want me to take Martles or Door?
Yes. I mean, it's not good. You don't even look like you're going to be white.
Yeah, I know. That's what I'm saying. What?
I don't know.
I'm going to take the tree.
That's fine.
Guess I'll take another Stratus Walk.
Yeah. It's really hard to be blue, though, after what you've got. This is just a train wreck.
Oh, yeah. This is a disaster.
Can color sort.
Sure.
How much differently do you think you would have drafted if it was like a big important Pro Tour draft?
Probably pretty similarly.
Yeah, I think extremely similarly. You've just got nothing.
Yeah. Hopefully I open like a really good rare and I can just...
Do you agree with like Butcher over the 3-1?
Probably.
Yeah. That is a good rare.
I could also just take Thassa's Emissary.
Yeah, that's a good card too. The Stratus Blocks are good with the white cards. Why, do you think you're going to be, like, blue-black somehow?
Could be blue-white, blue-black. This is tough. I only have 2 red cards.
It's extremely committal, but you're probably going to get red this pack.
What would you do?
It's definitely either the Thassa's Emissary or the Chain to the Rocks.
Of course.
I would take Chain to the Rocks.
Okay.
That's the highest upside.
I do agree.
Magma Jet, Hopeful Eidolon, or Fire Drink Crusader.
I think it's Hopeful Eidolon.
I think. I agree. Yeah, it is Hopeful Eidolon. Take that card. I would slam Dragon Mantle.
Yep.
That card's great.
Alright, let's hide some black, even though I'll probably end up unhiding it in 30 seconds.
God's Willing, I think. Yeah, God's Willing's quite good. It's kind of coming together. You actually have what looks to be a reasonable strategy.
Yeah, I just need some good cards.
Yeah. You have some good cards.
Yeah. The strategy is sound, though. I do agree.
Yeah. You have, like...
I have, like, 9 playables, which is good.
Yeah. Your Revoke Existence is not a card you want to play with. Getting 5 playables in the first pack is tough, but you're 4-for-4 in this pack.
Yeah. So. But they're not very good.
They're fine,
I agree. Chain to the Rocks is obviously...
Ooh. Chain to the Rocks is excellent.
I think I want to take Fanatic of Mogis.
Definitely take that card. That card is great. Chain to the Rocks is insane. Hopeful Eidolon is quite good. I think Chosen by Heliod. I'm not certain, though.
Not certain either. I do have this guy.
Yeah,
this
well, that's the Crunch Conscriptor is the reason I think you should take it.
Spirit Point Ariad or Battlewise Valor or Borderline Minotaur.
I think Borderline Minotaur is better than the Oriad because of the Fanatic, but it's Borderline Minotaur or Battlewise Valor.
I think I'm going to take Minotaur.
Go ahead. I don't see anything wrong with that. It's a close pick, though.
Yeah, just thinking. I'm going to take Minotaur. I only have 7 creatures.
I would take the Crusader. Yeah. You could play it.
Yeah, I could.
You kind of need 2 drops for the Loyal Pegasus.
Yeah.
And it looks like you're going to have enough heroes.
I'm just going to take Destructive Revelry, I guess. You take Sandals or Demolish.
I wouldn't take Destructive Revelry because you're never going to play it. I would take Demolish or Sandals, probably Sandals. Jeez,
wow,
that's
that
great.
Was good, yeah.
Yeah, that's extremely good. It's like cheap red permanent for your Fanatic of the Mogis. I would take Priest of Eros and probably intend to play it.
This could be like a 15 lander.
I mean, good luck getting that many playables. 10 playables in both the last 2 packs and 5 in the first pack. It's not easy to do.
Yeah.
But you're kind of on course, though.
Yeah.
What you lack in 2 drops, you make up for in 1 drops.
I lack for in 2 drops, I make up for in low power level.
Yeah, and bad cards.
Yeah.
Bountiful amounts of bad cards. You need ordeals. Just get only red and white ordeals in the last pack.
Or just all chained to the rocks.
Yeah, I would do that too if I was you. That Dragon Mantle is great in your deck. Yeah, take Evangel. Good cards, but you probably won't play with it. the Oaks. You need Cavalry Pegasus is what you need. What did we take over the first one, the Fanatic?
Probably.
Yeah, that's what you took.
Could use a Wingsteed Rider or two or ten or Fabled
Obviously,
Hero.
Obviously, those cards are all great.
Fabled Hero.
Phalanx Leader?
Yeah. That card's tough on my mana. I have like four red one drops.
You would still be so happy
obviously.
To see it. You would slam it.